And we have some breaking news at 11. A massive fish kill on Sanibel could keep beachgoers out of the water and off of the sand. NBC2 found the mess at Gulfside City Park on Sanibel Island. NBC2's Michael Coliani is there. He joins us now live with the details. Michael.
Yeah, Lisa, before I even walked down to the beach, I could certainly smell the dead fish in the air. And once I got down here, I walked about a quarter of a mile up and down the beach, and literally the beach is strewn with thousands and thousands of dead fish.
When Erin Netzelt and her friend Joyce Nardo made their way to Gulfside Beach tonight, they were looking for a little getaway.
I just like the sea air. It smells good out here, listening to the waves. It's just a natural way to relax and beat some stress.
To relax, hear the waves, yes, I love it here.
But they didn't expect to find this. Thousands of dead fish strewn across the beach and could likely be the result of red tide. The latest reports released today by Florida Fish and Wildlife show the algae bloom, which is common this time of year, has made its way back to Southwest Florida.
Yeah, it's a little fishy, but it is refreshing.
Fish kill can also be caused by a very slight increase or decrease in water temperature, as some fish species can be very sensitive to these types of environmental changes.
But for Erin and Joyce, they aren't letting a few fish kill their moonlit relaxation time on the beach.
When I heard what was going on, it didn't make a difference. I still put my chair right here in the sand and listening to the waves.
It doesn't matter what was at the beach. I'm just going to listen to the waves and smell the ocean air.
Now, FWC has made it easy for you to find out where these algae blooms could be in Southwest Florida. You can find out all that information on our website, so just log on to nbc-2.com. Reporting live on Sanibel, Michael Coliani, NBC.